Welcome everybody to another video of Ancient Greece Reloaded. Today we will talk about the famous Pleiades. By the way, if you like the video, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel so stay tuned for upcoming videos. Alright! The Pleiades were seven sisters, Maia, Alcyone, Asterope, Keleno, Taygete, Electra and Merope. Their parents were Atlas, a titan commanded by the god Zeus to hold up Earth, and Pleione, the mythical protectress of sailors. After a chance meeting with the hunter Orion, the Pleiades and their mother became the objects of his pursuit. To protect them from Orion's relentless amorous advances, Zeus changed them into a flock of doves, which he then set in the heavens. Zeus was also rumored to have fathered children with three of the sisters. That is also why the constellation of Orion still chases after the Pleiades even today, meaning after Orion failed to conquer them. The seven sisters are also known as the water girls or the ice maidens due to their association with the water, be it seas, rivers, rain, hail, snow, ice or frost. The Greek legends often refer to the sisters as Okeanides. Some sources claim that the name Pleiades originates from the ancient Greek word plein, meaning to sail. In the ancient Mediterranean world, the day that the Pleiades cluster first appeared in the morning sky, before sunrise, announced the opening of the navigation season. In more detail about the Pleiades, Maia is the eldest sister and known for her outstanding beauty as well as her solitary life. The story goes that despite her beauty, she was a shy, wife-like woman who preferred her own company and lived alone in the caves. The name Maia means mother in Latin, and in other translations, Maia also means nurse or great one. Maia was seen by the Romans as the spring goddess, which is why our fifth month is called May. At one time, her star shone brighter than any of the others. However, the next sister star, Alcyone, now shines brighter, which some say symbolizes sibling rivalry between the two sisters in the past. In Greek mythology, Alcyone, also known as Halcyon, the second sister, was known as the leader. During the Halcyon days, when the world was filled with joy, prosperity and tranquility, she watched over the Mediterranean Sea, making it calm and safe for sailors. The son of a morning star, Cheops, the king of Thessaly, and Alcyone were married and devoted to each other, until the day they deceived Zeus and Hera by pretending to be them. In a rage, Zeus waited for the lovers to separate before launching a thunderstorm over the seas, causing Cheops' boat to capsize and him to drown. Later, Zeus turned Alcyone and Cheops into the Halcyon birds so as for the couple to be together. Merope is more commonly accepted as the lost Pleiad because hers was the last star to be mapped by astronomers, and it's the faintest star in the cluster, not visible to the naked eye. Some legends suggest that she became lost because she hid her face in shame at marrying a mortal, King Sisyphus. Others say that Merope hid her face out of shame because her husband was a criminal, whose punishment was to roll a heavy stone up a hill to the edge of heaven, though it always rolled back down. There are similarities here to Merope's father, Atlas, who kept the weight of the world on his shoulders. Asterope. The Greek name of Asterope translates to star, and she is traditionally portrayed as one of the weaker sisters, perhaps because the star is one of the two that shines less brightly than the others. She was the mother of Inomaus by Ares, the god of war. Some versions of the myth claim that Inomaus was in fact her husband, not her son, and that after having four children together, he later became king of Pisa. Keleno is commonly translated as meaning melon or swarthy. Keleno, like Asterope, shines less brightly than the others, supposedly because she was once struck by lightning by Theon the Younger. However, she had many children, including sons Lycus and Chimaerus, part lion, dragon and god by the titan Prometheus, and sons Lycus and Nycteus by Poseidon, the god of the sea. Taygete. In the myths, Taygete, like Maia, valued her independence and lived alone in the mountains. Zeus also had his eyes set on Taygete and tried to seduce her. Before he could reach her, she ran into the arms of Artemis, who turned Taygete into a doe so that she could escape the clutches of Zeus. Hercules also tried to woo her. Electra, known as the third brightest star, Electra bore four children, one of which was Dardanus, who later became the founder of the ancient city of Troy. Some sources claim that Electra is the lost Pleiad after she vanished following the fall of Troy and Dardanus' death. Another version of the myth states that all seven sisters committed suicide because they were so saddened by either the fate of their father Atlas or the loss of their siblings, the Pleiades. In turn, Zeus, the ruler of the Greek gods, immortalized the sisters by placing them in the sky. There, these seven stars formed the star cluster known thereafter as the Pleiades. What is more, the Pleiades are known through various mythological accounts throughout the world. The Native Americans call them the Seven Star Girls. The Aboriginal legends call the Seven Sisters the Yugarmura Water Girls. In the Hindu legend, the Pleiades are collectively known in India as Kritika, the wives of the seven wise men named the Seven Rishis, or Seven Sages, or the six mothers of the war god Murugan, who developed six faces, one for each of them. In Japan, the Pleiades in Japanese culture are known as Subaru and are usually referred to as being seven stars. Subaru also means unite or unity in Japanese. In the account of Theodorus, the myth goes as follows. The Pleiades were called Atlantides after their father Atlas and Hesperides from their mother Hesperis, daughter of Hesperus, brother of Atlas, making him the uncle of his bride. These sisters excelled in beauty and chastity, and thus Busiris, the king of the Egyptians, was seized with desire to get the maidens into his power, and consequently he dispatched pirates by sea with orders to seize the girls and deliver them into his hands. Later on, Heracles conquered this prince when the latter attempted to sacrifice the hero. Meanwhile, the pirates who had seized the girls while they were playing in a certain garden and carried them off and fleeing swiftly to their ships had sailed away with them. Heracles came upon these pirates as they were taking their meal on a certain strand, and learning from the maidens what had taken place, he slew the pirates to a man and brought the girls back to Atlas. In return, the father was so grateful to Heracles for his kindly deed that he not only gladly gave him such assistance as his labor called for, but he also instructed him quite freely in the knowledge of astrology. The Greek poet Hesiod mentions the Pleiades several times in his Works and Days. As the Pleiades are primarily winter stars, because they are visible from about October to April in the northern hemisphere, the opposite periods for the southern hemisphere, they feature prominently in the ancient agriculture calendar. Here is a bit of advice from Hesiod. And if longing seizes you for sailing the stormy seas, when the Pleiades flee mighty Orion and plunge into the misty deep, and all the gusty winds are raging, they do not keep your ship on the wine dark sea, but, as I bid you, remember to work the land. That being said, remember guys to hit the like button and to subscribe to our channel, it would help us a lot. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for upcoming videos.